Hello students, welcome to the online session. I hope you all are watching all the sessions regularly. Today in this video we are going to revise science chapter 3, that is fiber to fabric. We will learn how fibers are converted into fabrics. Okay, let's begin.
Revision of class 6, science, chapter 3, fiber to fabric. What are fabrics? Fabrics are materials used for making clothes, curtains, bed sheets, towels, tablecloth, bags, etc. Fabric is made up of strands arranged together in horizontal and vertical patterns. Now, what are these strands? The loose thread that comes out from the piece of cloth are called yarns. So, fabric is made up of yarns arranged together. And these yarns are further made up of small and thin strands called fibers. So, fabrics are made up of yarns and yarns are further made up of fibers. In other words, several strands of fibers are twisted together to make yarns. And yarns are arranged together to make fabrics. There are two types of fibers, natural fibers and artificial fibers. We obtain natural fibers from plants and animals. Now, we will study some plant fibers. We obtain plant fibers from plants such as cotton and jute. Jute fiber is a soft and long natural fiber, as it has golden and silky shine. Therefore, it is also called as golden fiber. Jute plants are grown mainly in the fields of Bihar, Assam and West Bengal. Jute fibers are obtained from the stem of jute plants. Jute fibers are also obtained from outer skin of jute plant called ribbon. The jute plants are harvested at the flowering stage. Stems of jute plants are bundled and kept in slow running water for few days. During this time, the fiber become loose from the stem and can be easily separated. This process of extraction of jute fiber from the stem is called retting. The fibers are separated from rotting stem by hands. This process is known as stripping. Another plant fiber we will study is cotton. Cotton fibers are obtained from cotton plants. Cotton plants are grown in the fields having black soil and it needs a warm climate for its growth. In India, it is grown in Gujarat, Punjab, Haryana, Maharashtra, etc. The fruit of the cotton plant or a grown cotton ball is similar in size of that of lemon. After maturity, these cotton balls burst open and we see soft, fluffy, white cotton with seeds covered in it. Cotton and cotton balls can contain about 5 lakhs cotton fibers. Cotton is then picked from the balls with hands or with harvester. The cotton picked up from the plants has seeds in it. The seeds are separated from fibers by combing. This process of separating cotton seeds from cotton fibers is known as ginning. Previously, ginning was done by hands. Nowadays, well-developed machines are used for ginning. This is how we get cotton fibers. Now, how these fibers are converted to yarns? The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. Let's study spinning of cotton yarn. In this process, fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn out and twisted. These fibers are twisted continuously. By doing so, fibers come close to each other. They hold each other tightly and we get a long string. The long and strong string obtained by twisting fibers together is cotton yarn. Fabric is made from yarn. We get variety of fabric based on amount of twist in the yarn. A simple device used for spinning yarn is a hand spindle. It is also called takli. The famous hand-operated device used for spinning is called charkha. Mahatma Gandhi popularized it during independence movement. How these yarns are converted to fabrics? There are variety of methods for making fabrics from yarns. The two main methods are weaving and knitting. Weaving. The process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric is called weaving. Weaving of fabric is done on looms. A loom is a structure for making fabrics by weaving yarn or thread. Basically, a loom is a structure which is used to give support to your weave. A tightly held thread or yarn strung over the loom vertically is the warp thread or warp yarn. Another thread which is drawn through or inserted over and under the warp thread is the weft thread or weft yarn. With weft thread, it is possible to create different patterns and designs in the weave and therefore different designs in the fabrics. The looms are either hand operated or power operated. Another way of making fabric from fiber is by knitting. If you pull the yarn from a torn pair of socks, then a single yarn gets pulled out continuously. This is because in knitting we have loops. Socks and many other clothing items are made of knitted fabrics. Knitting can be done by hands. Knitting can be done on machines. Weaving and knitting are used for making different kinds of fabric. History of clothing material. In ancient times, people used the bark and big leaves of trees or animal skins and furs to cover themselves. After people began to settle in agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grass into mats and baskets. The early Indians wore fabrics made out of cotton that grew in the regions near the river Ganga. Flax is also a plant that gives natural fibers. In ancient Egypt, cotton as well as flax were cultivated near the river Nile and were used for making fabrics. In those days, stitching was not known. People simply draped the fabrics around different parts of their body. Many different ways of draping fabrics were used. With the invention of the sewing needle, people started stitching fabrics to make clothes. Stitched clothes have gone through many variations since this invention. Even today, sari, dhoti, lungi or turban is used as an unstitched piece of fabric. So, this chart summarizes the entire chapter. The fibers which are obtained from plants, animals or chemicals after spinning are converted into yarns. Yarns are converted into fabric by weaving and knitting. And ultimately, fabrics are converted into clothes by stitching. So, I really hope that now you have learned all the steps from fiber to fabric. Thank you for watching the video.